forth where you work. He's like, hey, here's how you handle that stuff, and blah, 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 blah. And and later when it clicked, and what I started realizing is I got into the workforce and college, you know, I was doing night school to finish school because I never had the opportunity to go to college. And, I finished it through, you know, doing night school as I'm working and then running the school as well. So I'm teaching three nights a week, going to night school two nights a week for 8 years, and then working. And everything that I did, it always come back to how would I do that if I was in karate? What did karate teach me? And, you know, it's our guest speaker is Mylas Copeland. And, most of you know Mylas, yes? Okay. He's not allowed to ask you if you're driving a Toyota. But I say that because we talk all the time. We talk as friends all the time, but a lot of time in business, and sometimes they go, you know what I picked up from martial arts that I apply in my operation. So here's a man who is the general manager of both Audi and Toyota, two automotive dealerships, not one. He does the Peacekeepers, which is a big organization that raises money for fallen soldiers, fallen police officers, and their families. And most of the time, you see him on radio and TV, and he almost speaks at every event. That's why he's here. You know, he couldn't turn me down. He speaks at everybody else's event. So, but he does a lot for the community. But I think, for sure, Mylas is a good person to talk about. I wanted to be a guest speaker because I know he uses the black belt principles above and beyond just the mat. So, with Mylas Copeland.
First thing I was told is I can't talk long, so I won't.
Thank you, sir.
First of all, to those of you up front, some of you guys that have gotten degrees, but especially to those of you who are just achieving the rank, congratulations. It is a journey. It is a tribute, and it's a testament to really what you put your mind to. You're also in a fraternity now. It's a club. And I want you guys to stop for just a minute and look at the people behind you. That's family. There is something different about you once you achieve the rank. You walk a little different. You stand up a little straighter. You smile a little broader. As Hachi said, 600, 700 people in the academy. They're always enrolling. Look to your left and to your right. There's not a lot of people in that row. But beyond the mat, once you step outside, once you get into the world, what does black belt really mean? And that's what really Hachi wanted me to say. As he said, two, three times a week, we're talking about what the black belt upbringing and teaching does for us. Number one, I think it's going to give you patience. I mean, there are times that I look back, and we all have those times in our lives when we just want to absolutely go berserk. Maybe not you guys yet. But as adults, especially, things really kind of get to us. I fall back oftentimes, I'm thinking, not a big deal. We can handle it differently. We can approach it with a different perspective. I'll never forget when I tested for black belt, I still remember the people across from me. I can still see Butler's gloves coming left and right in fury. You never forget it. But you also always go back, and every time I see the people in the back row, it's a hug and it's an embrace. And it's a recollection of memories. And it's confidence when we walk outside those doors on how we take care of life. And so I think the one thing that I always attribute to the black belt process is that it is much harder, in my opinion, to be a black belt than to become a black belt. Let that sink in for just a minute. it is much harder to be a black belt than to become a black belt. Because to be is to live the life. It is to carry yourself differently. It is to approach things systemically. And you're not just any black belt. And I know I'm going to get crucified for saying that. But you're not. You're a black belt under one of the most renowned instructors in America. You're a black belt under the tutelage of the one who was handpicked by some of the greatest in the martial arts world. Not only is he a dear friend, he's one of the greatest out there. You are one of his black belts. There is a poem by Rudyard Kipling, and to me it sums up what being a black belt is. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you but make allowance for their doubting too, if you can wait and not be tired by waiting or being lied about, you don't get unwise. Or being hated. Don't give way to hating. And yet not look too good nor talk too wise. Dream. And not make dreams your master. Think and not make thoughts your pain. If you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same. You can make one heap of all your wings and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss and lose. Start again at your beginnings. And never breathe a word. It says, if you can force your heart, nerve, and sinew to serve their turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there's nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, walk with kings and lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you but not too much, if you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of a distance run, yours is the earth and everything that is in it. Which is more, it says, you'll be a man, my son. And to me, that epitomizes what a black belt is. Sometimes you have to wait. You get tired. Sometimes you feel worn out. Out there in life, remember what you came through. Remember where you started. Know that if you just keep going, when there's nothing in you, when Hanchi said, hit one more time, when Soki said, get up in base one more time, and everybody else sat back and you made the class, and you continue the ranks, to continue the stripes, that's life. That's being a black belt's all about. 87 employees, a multi-million dollar operation we run, and every single day,